Alright, so this is the name that we have come up with for our film. So basically we had a couple ideas before our idea that we'll get to in a minute. But we had the idea for a park bench and just have like a... Basically we saw a video of a conversation and it was just like a short on YouTube. And it was about an old man, a grumpy old man sitting on a bench. And a kid comes along and he basically brightens the old man's mood, and we wanted to do something like that, something emotional like that. And we came up with a second idea for a pub. You came up with this one, you can talk about that.
So I kind of was thinking about the whole thing of like when you're thinking of a film, you're trying to think of popular scenes you could relate it to. So I thought of Simon Pegg and Nick Frost's opening scene in Shaun of the Dead. And I wanted it to be kind of like a quick, witty conversation. And obviously with Edgar Wright is like a lot of foreshadowing. So I just wanted it to be kind of similar in a way of like just quick, witty humour between two mates. But that got as far as the park bench as well, so we didn't decide on that.
So before we get into the idea, we decided our roles. I'm going to be the producer, Ryan's the director, and we're both going to be the DOP and editor. Our idea is basically a video call that takes place during COVID. Our characters are going to talk about various different things on video call like you would have done in during COVID. And so they're going to go off topic a lot, and they're going to be talking about a lot of different subjects. Our main part of the idea is that one of the characters is against lockdown and one of the characters is for lockdown for personal reasons, and so they're gonna have like kind of a fight about it, but not they're gonna like talk about it, disagree about it, but they're still friends. And at the end of the film, the one that's against lockdown will show up at the other character's house and try and like socialize, even though they're not allowed to. Do you have anything to add to that, actually?
No.
Okay. We both came up with the different characters. I came up with mine, which is called Christopher Walker. He's age 21, and basically his character ended up getting all of his personality from his older brother that doesn't live in the house anymore, so they're not together during COVID. And so basically that's kind of like having a vinyl collection, proper 90s style, and basically like playing vintage games and stuff like that.
So for my character, I decided the name of Benjamin Stone, and he's 22. He's, as a character in general, he's kind of bland and likes to stick to his own opinion, and that's where, even though him and Christopher are really good friends, they do have their main differences. The main difference, especially with like the idea of the film, is that Benjamin is kind of against COVID and kind of against like lockdown rules, and doesn't really see it as a big issue in terms of socializing. He doesn't really see the effects that COVID's having on people's lives, and just doesn't really care, like kind of does his own thing and only cares about himself. His fashion's also very, very much like Christopher's in ways, and all round he's, you can get along with him, but you might not agree with the opinions that he has.
The one thing I forgot to mention about my character was that the reason why he's for lockdown and for all of these like restrictions is because he has a nan that's very vulnerable to COVID, and so that's going to be portrayed in the conversation where he's telling Benjamin, no, we cannot see each other because of this, and I don't want to put my nan at risk. We created a playlist. This is like a mixture of our characters, so like both of our characters created this together to listen to during lockdown. So we've got This Is a Life, Left Outside Alone, basically like 90s music, but also mixed with musical theatre music. and film music. So we've got some costume design. This is for my character. It's very like indie type stuff. It's quite 90s, 21st century, if that makes sense. It's a bit quirky, so like having random objects as necklaces and things like that.
And this is my character design. So I kind of went for, yeah, again, just very sleek and ironed out. Likes his jewellery, kind of like his incognito all the time, just like cap, sunglasses, and just very clean cut, bland in a way.
So we did character profiles on our characters. This is mine. I won't go into detail about it, but mine is quite like a introverted person, very like spiritualistic type person, has a lot of feelings, like sympathizes with people.
And then this one's mine. So I got entrepreneur, and obviously trying to answer the questions in the way my character would. It obviously gave the results of just somebody who's very cocky and like only for themselves, really. So these were my results I got back from answering the questions.
And then we briefly looked at audience. We would like to look at audience more, but basically we want to target people who were like in their mid-teens to late teens during COVID, because this is the time where they would want to go out with their friends, but they can't, so they're looking to like try and socialise through video call, which is how our film is going to be shown. But we do want a divide of audience, so people who side with Christopher's views and people who side with Benjamin's views. So we want to try and put in both perspectives, but we're not quite sure how we're going to do that yet. And yeah, that's everything. Any questions?
Any questions, guys? Any feedback? Aspen.
Not questions, as a more feedback. The characters seem quite samey. They seem very surface level. They don't have a lot to them. And I know, obviously, it's just a pitch, so you can't go into it as much as you probably want to. But they do feel very much, oh, he likes this, he likes that. And it's not very in-depth, and I don't get a feel that these are going to be compelling enough characters to have a two-way conversation between themselves. So
yeah, I get what you mean. Kind of like, we didn't want to go too into detail with them here.
Yeah.
But we do have, like, we are going into the background characters of, like, their families and how they run and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So, like, with my character, I want to have more of like a strict parents type thing with,
like, sticking to the rules.
Yeah, and like I say, with the older brother getting the fashion and the basically how he looks at the world from his brother, because they were close when they were younger. So I would want to go into that, like, with the film. So for example, having my character bring up props. And talk about them, say that they were either his brothers or there were some sort of family members, and try and go into that past family life, especially with, since his nan is going to be living with him.
Yeah.
I don't think I put that in there, actually. I'm going to have it so that his nan is living with him, so he can't go out and see people. So I'm going to have that be like a bit of a conflict as well, because he wants to see his brother. His brother doesn't live with them anymore, and so he's kind of got this conflict. He wants to, like, obviously keep care of his nan, but also, like,
And well, to be honest, with mine, I haven't really went too much into mine, because if there's going to be anything added more to mine, it's not going to be probably as much detail as Lee, because my character is very much, I want to give him the title of, like, social introvert. Like, he likes the company of the people around him in his circle. But other than that, he's very closed off from even some of his family.
Yeah.
And that kind of plays into his opinions on lockdown.
Yeah.
So mine will have a lot more on it, but it'll be he'll be very closed-born off compared to the other character.
Just make sure you don't delve into making him just monotone and no personality, that kind of thing. Yeah.
Hmm.
Anybody else? Who's your actors?
Well, we've got an actor for Christopher, but he's my boyfriend. But we are still like trying to look for an actor for Benjamin.
We've had thoughts on who to use. Initially, I thought of using Harry, just because, mainly going off appearance, because Harry looks a lot older than he is. But we'll have to do more research into actors.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, most of my feedback you've probably heard already, like, you know, because we've talked a lot about this project, but my main, I mean, Aspen's got a point, like, you know, my main issue would be is not making sure that there is a the characterization works for the conflict, like, you know, you can see that. Then the other bit is how you make, because we see, you know, there's films out there like the, oh, what's the one with Korean actor? There's quite a few films out there anyway with that are mainly based on being, you know, online, like, you know, and kind of video calling. I don't want you to be caught in that trap of, like, you know, seeing the characters on the screens all the time.
Yeah.
So I want to be able to see them cutting back and forth to what they're doing, like, you know.
Yeah.
Fair enough, while they're on the screen, because that's the way we used to communicate. But I do want you to play with blocking, like, you know, so we're talking about making sure everybody's moving in it, even if they're on a laptop, like, you know, so making sure that they're moving from room to room or something like that, or they're moving, you know.
Well, with the main thing with Benjamin, Ryan's character, he's moving constantly because he's on the way to Christopher's house.
Right.
And with my character, he's going to be moving around, like I said before with you, that my character likes sewing, he likes playing guitar, and he likes Rubik's Cubes and that sort of thing. So I can have him like going and looking for like a bit of thread, or looking for a project that he was working on, or fiddling with something, or
so you're constantly giving him an action.
Yeah, or like he takes his laptop downstairs to go and make a drink.
Right.
Something as simple as that, just that you would do during COVID times. Like, there's not much you can do, have something there.
The other thing, have you thought about you've done quite a bit on character, but have you thought about, you know, there's things that we weren't able to do during lockdown, like, you know, that might feed into it. Like, one thing is getting a haircut, like, you know, a lot of people can get haircuts, like, you know, a lot of people stop shaving because who could be arsed, you know, stuff like that, like, you know, so that might be worth. And also, like, you know, if he's traveling, finding somewhere where you can kind of make it look like nobody's out.
See, what our idea was is doing it at night time, so you can see the street lamps going past.
Oh, that'd be good.
Doing that sort of thing. Or like,
also, with the whole thing of like going to be filming soon over winter, it's going to be getting dark earlier anyways, and it plays into the character a bit more of, like, he knows he's doing wrong, but he's still out there anyways, so he'll go out at night when there's even less people, because all I remember from COVID really is you could go out for an hour, like within a certain radius of your house, just for air. It kind of plays into the character more, that he's like, yeah, I'm going to go out, but I'll go out at night.
That makes sense. And the last thing is just need a bit more work on audience. The audience isn't quite there yet. So you need to think about not just about who it is, but also how you're getting it to them, how you're going to exhibit it, how you're going to deliver it.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I think it could be good. Just make sure you get your shit in your blog as well.
I do have things I need to put on there, to be fair.
I've got stuff on there already.
And you track your entire journey. Not a small part of it.
Yes.
Ryan. Yeah?
Me?
Yeah, because
other people do it as well.
Huh?
Other people do it as well.
Yeah, dude. It was basically skin makeup, and that was it. That was the entirety of your last project. Okay. Full journey.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Right. Cool.